Good morning, everyone. This is Deepak here. Today I plan to teach you, even want to tell you about the first lesson of class 12th Vistas, the third level. What is third level? Level means here the type of word which is in your imagination. You know, this is the lesson, this is the story which has been written by a great thriller writer whose name is written here, Jack Finney. He has written about the thrill, illusions, imaginations. So here in this lesson, I would like to first tell you the three main characters. The one is Charlie, who is in illusion. Another, his wife Lucia. And the third character, a cyclist, his friend Sam. These are the main characters in this story. And as I told you, what is the third level? It is the part of illusion. Actually, the narrator of this story is, you know, bored up, puzzled of the lot of chaos found in this world. So he wanted to go in such a world which is full of peace, love, affection, joy. So here I would like to add, in this third level, the Charlie I think you are getting my point. It's the story of a New York, and the site is the Grand Central Station. The station is very much illumined and, you know, developed, looking very nice, modern, full facilities and everything is there. Charlie is a 31-year-old city resident. And he is talking about the third level he experienced in his illusion. He calls it a walking dream, wish fulfillment. Means you want to escape from the world and you want to migrate to the another world which is favorable, which is very nice, where you feel very calm and cool and, you know, peace. And there is no one your enemy, all are loving people, everywhere there is a love and affection. In such a world, he wanted to be, and that's why he is talking about that level, and that is called third level. Level may be your destination. And the central station, the Grand Central Station of New York, has only two levels. Charlie's psychology, by saying that the modern world is full of fear, insecurity and war and lot of worries and anxieties, and everybody, even me, you and all people, want to escape from this world and want to go somewhere where there is a happiness. And he is having a hobby of stamp collecting, and this is also a kind of an indicator of being escaping from the worlds where you are living now. And the Grand Station I'm talking about It was a very maze to the Charlie. And while walking in that station to the subway, what is the subway? Subway means the underway and a kind of passes, you know, a kind of corridor. So when he was passing through that, he had lost his way in that, going through the corridors. In a couple of time he found. And one time he entered the lobby of the Roosevelt Hotel. And hotels, you all know, had corridors. And he appeared at an office building. He saw an office building that was three blocks away. Means a very three block distances was there. However, this time he loses his way. He lost his way. And something unique occurs. That is, unique means strange. Strange appears to him. He reaches the third level. So the one person is thought into the, you know, lost into the thoughts. He goes into the illusion. He imagines some kind of, you know, a different world. But actually he is existing somewhere else, in the, some other words. But he goes in somewhere else. So he lost in the third level. Third level is a kind of different world. Up in that different world, he finds something different. Charlie keeps walking, turning left, sloping downwards, and he touches an architecturally old station. Architecturally old station means which is not of his time, the architecture style which was of old time. He's totally different from the two familiar level where he was, he had already walked. Everything was very different in that third level. Moreover, the old small room with fewer ticket counters and train gates, a wooden information booth was there, and wavering open flame gas, lights and brass, sprinkles and everything. And all this reminded him about the architecture of the, you know, 18th century. I'm talking about, while he is in 20th century. The world he sees, 11 June 1894, and when he tries to buy two tickets, he realizes that he needs old currency. Up, he began to exchange that old currency with the new currency. So he paid 300 new currency, 300, and in return he got 200. So it was a tremendous loss for him, but he adjusted it. He always wanted to travel to the Galesburg with his wife Lucia. It was in mind, because it was a wonderful town with a big old, you know, frame houses, huge lawns, and even, you know, tremendous trees. So the place was so pleasant, and the long summer dusk, and where people have ample of time to pass peacefully, no work, only leisure time. So the next day during lunch, he exchanges $300 with, and in return he gets $200. But anyhow, this $100 loss was nothing for him, because he thought that in the world, in the third level, the things would be more cheap, you know, will be cheaper. So he did not worry about the $100 loss. He was happy to change it. And what happened? He never could find again that corridor of the third level where he was in the illusion. When his wife came to know about the matter, you know. So she told you to stop looking at that. Unexpectedly, his friend Sam Winner is a kind of psychiatrist. Who is psychiatrist? The person who studies the psychology of the man, that is called psychiatrist. And they all look for that till the weekends. And Sam was the one whom Charlie shares his idea about the girl's work. So the all story goes in that, you know, illusion only. Charlie inherited the hobby of stamp collection from his grandfather, this I tell you. And while looking at the stamp collection, Charlie finds a letter that was earlier not there. So it has the postmark on a, you know, faded 6-cent stamp. Cent is actually the kind of currency, as a kind of money. 6-cent stamp with a picture of President Garfield. It means that time the stamp was, you know, picture was Garfield on the picture. And the date on the envelope was written 18 July 1894. It was written by, you know, Charlie's grandfather in Gale's work, and it was addressed to the Charlie. And in the letter, Sam is a psychiatrist friend. He tells Charlie that he has reached Gale's works, and he invites him also along with his wife Lucia. After going to stamp and coin shop, he comes to know that Sam exchanged $800 for old currency bills to establish his business in the Galesburg. Sam was none other than Charlie's psychiatrist. Again, I'm telling you. So the conclusion here comes here that the narrator in this writing, in this story, wants to escape from the modern world, which is full of cures, lot of hue and cry, you know, greed, lust for money, materialism. He wanted to go away from this world of materialism and wanted to enter or reside in such a world where only, you know, peace is there. If you remember about quite old time, if you think about your grandpa's or forefather's time, so there was no lot of, you know, rush. People were not running behind the money, and they all had peaceful time, totally, everyone was enjoying the nature, you know, and people were producing things, you know, people were not greedy lot, if you think about the old times. But this modernism made people, you know, tempted about the, you know, what you can say, materialism. They all are. Or everybody, we also have 24 hours, they also had 24 hours, they never said we don't have time, they didn't have time, but we always say we don't have time. Why? Because we are just mad about collecting, materialistic we are become, instead of realistic. So we need to become realistic instead of materialistic. So that's all about this lesson, and if you have any queries, please send me your queries. Thank you.